Next concept is one-line diagram. So these electrical power system are extremely complicated electrical networks. So these are geographically spread over very large areas. So generally these are a three-phase networks, each consisting of conductors, generators, transformers, breakers, disconnector, etc. So in fact, the power system are such a complex and complicated conventional diagram to showing all these connections, it is very difficult. So that's why we have to go with some concise way of communicating for the basic arrangement of the power system components. So this is done with the help of the single line diagram. So that's coming to that, the definition. So this is the concise way of communicating the basic arrangement of the power system components. So this is done with the help of the single line diagram. It is called as one line diagram. So this will show exact the electrical connections of the circuits. So in the name itself, it will show that. So all the component is represented by considering the all the three phases. Okay, so this is universally accepted for the making of the electrical connections of the complicated networks. So we have a different set of the components. So it is very difficult, what we told that it is very difficult for us to understand what are the components we have. So that's why you will understand what is the symbolic representation considering the component. The first one is a line or the cable, just we'll write it as a straight line. So in the case of circuit breaker, we'll write it as some rectangular box or star like a structure. So if there is a rotating machine, we'll write it as a circle. Okay, two winding transformer, maybe a resistance and reactance, or another way of representation is primary and secondary. This is the three phase a power transformer. Okay, three winding, it's not three phase, the three winding transformer. So primary, secondary, tertiary. Okay, same as the two winding transformer. Okay, so these are the things. Generally it is a reactance and a circle, we'll use it for most of the times. Then this is the current transformer. Okay, then we have potential transformers. Okay, then the three phase, we know delta, this is a star. So then coming to that, the three phase star connection is neutral, solidly grounded. Okay, this is nothing but solidly grounded. This is star connection is grounded with the help of the reactor. Okay, then next one we have three phase star, which is neutral grounded through a resistor. So why these things are important? So these star connection with the proper grounding is important when subjected to that we have a fault condition. Okay, earlier we are supposed to use a reactance connected to a ground in the case of generators. Now they are going for with the help of the resistor grounding. Okay, it having its own advantages and the disadvantages of it. Considering one of the example, that is generator having a rating of 30 MVA and 10.5 kV, it is X double dash is nothing but subtransient reactance having 1.6 ohms. Then generator G2 having 15 MVA, 6.6 kV, subtransient reactance of 1.2 ohm. Generator G3 having 25 MVA, 6.6 kV, subtransient reactance of 0.56 ohm. So transformer 1 is 3 phase, 15 MVA. So this you have to be very careful that how the transformer is connected, okay, 33 bar 11, and reactance having 15.2 ohms per phase, considering on ST side, okay. So then the transformer T2 having 15 MVA, 33 bar 6.6 kV, the reactance of 16 ohm on considering ST side. Then we have a transmission line having the resistance of 20.5 ohm per phase. Then there is a load of 15 megawatt, 11 kV, 0.9 power factor lag. Another load, 40 megawatt, 6.6 kV, 0.8 power factor lag. So the corresponding single line diagram, which is considering for a symbolic representation, which is shown here. Okay. This is generator 1, which is connected star with neutrally grounded. Okay. And transformer T1. You have to be very careful here. It is a star and grounded. T2 is also star and it is a delta. Okay, primary is star, secondary is delta. We have two generators, another generators, generator 2 and 3. Okay, these ratings are given here. Okay, there are the two loads. This is the one load 1 and this is the load 2. So just to imagine that if wanted to write all the values in a diagram, so it is a such a complicated devices. So that's why single line diagram will help us. So most of the time, so either they will mention the circuit breaker, or sometimes they won't mention it is a circuit breaker. It is not required, because we are not interested in to see what is the rating of the circuit breaker. So anyhow, these are all the things we can use it for the power system protection devices. Okay, that will help. So during that condition, this will help. Now it is not required. So this is one of the way of the concise way of representing the network. Next concept, we have impedance diagram. Although by considering that one line diagram, which will carries concise information of the system, but cannot be used directly to determine the performance of the system under load condition, or when there is a fault occurs in the system. So hence we need to have some simplified way of drawing this network. So by considering that equivalent circuit of the system to for the purpose of analysis under aforesaid condition, so this impedance diagram can be utilized to make it this. So that is nothing but it is impedance diagram which is obtained by replacing each component of the power system by its single phase equivalent circuit. Okay, what are the assumptions we will make it? Okay, first thing is the single phase transformer equivalents are shown as ideals with the impedance on appropriate side. So this is one of the thing which are going to make it means. So if there is a transformer, we have drawn that equivalent circuit. That equivalent circuit can be utilized to draw an impedance diagram. Okay. Then magnetizing reactance of the transformers are negligible. So we are going to neglect, because if we go on inserting this magnetizing circuit into the system, it won't make any sense, because whatever the losses which you are considering, it is around 1 to 2%. This can be neglected. Then we have generators are represented as a constant voltage source with the series resistance for the reactors. Okay. Then we have transmission line, which is approximately equivalent to that the pi network. Then loads are assumed to have a passive or represented by series branch of resistance and reactance. Okay. Since these balanced conditions we are going to assume, and the neutral grounding impedance do not appear in the system. So let's considering with the one die diagram, how we are going to draw a impedance diagram. Let's see, this is the one of the generator. Okay, this is the source of impedance, source of EMF. Okay, this is the equivalent impedance what I drawn at the earlier case. Okay, this is the resistance and reactance. Coming to that, the load A we have, that is, it is a resistance and reactance. Then coming to the transformer, So this is what the equivalent impedance. Okay. So we have primary and secondary resistance and reactance of the transformer. Then coming to that, this is the equivalent circuit for the transmission line. Consider it is a pi network. Okay. Y by 2 and the impedance. Similarly, this is for the transformer, primary and secondary. Okay. Excitation and load B we have. That is considering resistance and reactance and generator, the same as generator 1 and the 2, okay, source of EMF and the impedance. This is what means from right from the generator to the load, we are considering it as an equivalent diagram. That's we'll call it as impedance diagram. Although this is somewhat complicated, so hence we are not going with the impedance diagram. So we need some concise way of the information, that we'll consider it is a reactance diagram. So what are the things we are going to make it? We are going to assuming to draw a reactance diagram. The first one is resistance is neglected during the fault analysis because it is act like in short circuit. So this causes very, very negligible error in the error since the resistance are negligible. Okay. So generally we will neglect the load and the transmission line capacitances are ineffective and the magnetizing current of the transformer also negligible. So these are the things which is required. So this is one of the question is important. So draw a equivalent reactance diagram for synchro generator, motor, this is the transformer and the transmission lines. So coming to this, the synchro generator, what we told that it is the equivalent representation subject to the reactance diagram means we are considering not the impedance, we are considering it is the reactance of the diagram. So this is the equivalent, that's what we talked in the previous cases that there is a source of EMF in place of ZS, we are considering it is XS. Okay, it is a equivalent circuit subjected to that single phase equivalent circuit for the three phase network. Okay, EZ is nothing but source of EMF across generator. This is a synchronous reactance. The current is going out of the network. That is, we can write it as IG, generated current. Okay, generator current. So similarly, it is looks like the same both generators and some motors. Okay, source of reactance and the EMF source of EMF. That is EM for the motor and this is the synchronous reactance for the motor. It is taking the current, that's why we'll write it as IM. It is a motor current which is drawing from the network. And coming to that, this is the transformer and the transmission line. So just we are writing this is a series reactance. Okay, let's we can have example of this. So what I had given in the previous case, that is a one line diagram. So by considering this, we have derived a reactance diagram for transformers, sorry, generators, transformer load A, transformer 2, this is generator 1, generator 2, okay, all these things. Now we are, I am not going with the deep concept for what is this, which is connected in the star and the, it is grounded through a reactance, all those things. Just we are looking at the one line diagram. Okay, so by considering this, we can draw a reactance diagram. So first coming to this, this is a generator. Generator can be written as this is XS and the EG, a reactance and source of EMF. This is the reactance and the source of EMF. That's what we can call it as generator G1. Then what we have, it is a transformer T1. So this is the XT1. How we need to draw this is just a series reactance. So coming to the transmission line, so this is the equivalent, this is the transmission line. Next we have transformer T2. Okay, this is the transformer T2. Okay, this is same as the transmission line. Okay, series reactance X. Okay, T2 is nothing but refer to the transformer. 2 is represent for the transformer 2. Okay, similarly for the generators we have generator 2 and generator 3. It is same as synchro generator. Okay, XS and the EG. Okay, EG and this is the XS. We can make it as, in place of XS, you can make it as XG. Okay, generator reactance. for the generator 2, and this is the EMF, okay, EG2, generated EMF for the generator 2, similarly for the generator 3. So one thing you can see to here, this the load A and the load B, it is considered as a static load, that's why we are neglecting this. If it is dynamic load, we can consider that, okay, we can consider it is same as the synchronous motor, if it is. If not, we can neglect. If it is, we have only the resistor, we can neglect it. That's why, so all the network what we describe, it is in the form of a single line diagram. In place of that, writing in the form of the impedance diagram, we'll go for a reactance diagram. So that's why these things is plays an important role throughout this subject. So that's why you're supposed to remember this, the component and the equivalent circuit for generator, motor and the transmission line for this network.